Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest is a welcomed addition to Bravo's Married to Medicine. She brings her class, beautiful spirit, and military grit to the show.
Oh, yes, she does. And I'm definitely happy that she's a part of Married to Medicine because she makes the crew a little bit better. Please welcome our friend back to the show, Dr. Contessa Metcalf.
Yay! Hi. Contessa!
Hi, David. Look at you.
Hey, gorgeous.
Hello, gorgeous.
Thank you so much for having me.
Sit on down, girl.
Thank you, thank
Look
you,
how
thank
cute you are, Contessa.
Thank you. Early in the morning, too.
Always
huh?
so bright.
thank you.
This is all of the time. You always welcome us with a beautiful smile. You have such a radiant spirit.
Thank
I want
you.
To say that. And this is all of the time. I really love that about you, Contessa.
I get it from my mama, girl. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
So. Speaking of mama, what was your mommy duties like this Memorial Day? How did you spend your Memorial Day weekend?
Always chasing and running after these kids. Yes, girl. Mm-hmm. I mean, you feel like you invite people over, but you spend the whole time like hosting and taking care of everyone. So you never get to do anything yourself.
No.
So I'm used to it, and I love it, and I embrace it, and I'm happy to be able to do it. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
Now, the birthday.
Oh, my goodness, girl.
You decided to take all three of the children that you have and create one big birthday bash
for
them.
I did. Yes.
I got there a little bit late, but did you think that was a good idea?
Oh, my goodness. It was, so we had a carnival-themed birthday party for the kids, which we're going to show, so you'll see the season. It was crazy, but I call it my apology party. So, Quad knows I went back to school, and of course, when mommies get busy, sometimes we think something is not a big deal, but then the kids will remind you, my baby turned 5. Mm-hmm. I didn't do a birthday party for her, and she did not let it go. And so then 1, 2, and 3 kids all said, where's my birthday party? We just did a combined big event for everybody.
Mm-hmm. It was probably like 200 kids there.
It was crazy.
Oh my God.
It was a zoo. It really was. It was a carnival.
It was.
Horses and trains. It was nuts.
Was it just you and your husband? Or did you have some reinforcements?
I did, but I'm a bit of a micromanager. Mm-hmm. It's hard to communicate what's in your head to someone else, and so I tried to make sure that all the stuff that I wanted still got there. So I ordered stuff. I did my own stuff too. So the party planner did her thing, and I did mine. And together, we had lifeguards. We had 2 lifeguards.
Okay, yeah.
We had some people that we just hired to kind of corral
just
the
be
children.
Around, right.
And then the parents really stayed around because it was just so many. I mean, it was so many kids.
By the time I got there. Contessa was woe thin.
I was.
Had to be
woe thin to the floor, child.
Yeah. I said, look at this, baby. My God.
T-shirt and no shoes. It was bad.
Yeah.
What else was you going to wear?
Girl, I'm telling you.
Child.
So, but it was great. The kids had I still get text messages.
For them, though.
I really do.
Yeah.
And
it was beautiful.
It was great.
Mm-hmm.
Now, at one point in the show, you decided to step away from Married to Medicine and be a full-time mom.
Yes.
And now you're working back on the show again. Why did you decide that it was important to leave and come back? And you worked on your master's degree as well. So what made you do that? And how do you feel coming back from that?
So it's interesting. When you are a working mom, you're always kind of thinking the other side is much better. You know, I just need to be a stay-at-home mom. It's going to be much better. And then for work people who stay at home, they always think working is better.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And so when I was working and we had some help, when I suddenly lost my help, and we don't have like a lot of family, we don't have grandmothers anymore, I felt compelled to take care of my own dang on kids.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I didn't want to just pull some stranger off the street because of convenience purposes and put them in my home and give them carte blanche with my children.
Right.
Yeah, that's a lot.
That's my responsibility, ultimately.
Yeah.
And then I also, like I said, I've been having that itch and I needed to scratch it. So I did it for a while, but I realized that my purpose is...
It's like a little mommy guilt.
Yes, it is.
It is,
but I've let that go.
Yeah.
I've let that go, and I realized the kids are really resilient and they look at you, and especially like I'm a doctor.
Mm-hmm.
And if every doctor who happens to be a woman decided to stop practicing medicine...
What will we do?
Because of their children.
I mean, exactly. Because I'm telling you, most of my doctors, if not all of them, are women.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
And they have children.
Mm-hmm.
So
speaking of... women being physicians, what do you think the most gratifying or the most rewarding part of being a doctor is for you?
For me, it's really when people tell me, I didn't know that a doctor could look like you.
Mm-hmm.
That was the most important thing that I would say, like that kind of gets me through my day. When people walk up to me or older people who said, you know what, when I was little, I never had a doctor that looked like you.
Mm-hmm.
And little girls will say to me, I want to be a doctor.
Wow.
So that is probably the most important thing that kind of keeps me going and keeps me motivated to keep coming back.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Now, Contessa, you're not the new kid on the block anymore.
Not anymore.
No, she's not.
And you kind of was trying to get your footing in the beginning.
Yes.
But now the much your foot is down.
Yes,
okay?
Right. That's right.
And you stand up for yourself.
That's right.
You don't play with these
especially
people.
Especially this season.
Yeah.
Especially
but I didn't know why they wanted to mess with you, because I saw the military pictures.
Right,
you can really put somebody in a chokehold and just and settle all this.
Yeah, yeah.
But how do you feel like now that you're kind of, you know, finding your footing and finding your way? What is Married to Medicine like for you now?
Well, now it really is like a sisterhood. Like, mm-hmm. you get to know people better, and you realize that some of the things that people will say is not personal, it's just the way they are. Mm-hmm. And so it was great. I've now evolved to the point of this is just hanging out with my girlfriends and my sisters.
Yeah.
Even if we argue, sometimes we still love each other.
We do, and I love you, dear. But we have to wrap right now.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
That's
Listen,
okay.
thank you so much for being with
Yay.
Us. If you are staying the entire time, then Contessa's going to join us over at the table. Mm-hmm. How about that?
We are back on Sister Circle Live with Dr. Contessa of Married to Medicine.
Yes.
And bring her down to the table so she can chat with us a little longer.
Yes. So, of course, you and your husband, Scott, who's also a doctor, have truly found balance and teamwork.
Oh, no.
How are you able to do that as working parents? Or wait a minute, I would say it's constant evolution.
Okay.
And the problem is that sometimes, and I don't know, you know, we all married people, we understand how this works. 1 year is just smooth sailing, and the next year is like a roller coaster, mm-hmm. and you just like don't know what happened. The only thing that changed was the calendar date, you know?
Yeah.
And so we struggle with that.
Yeah.
Oof. Balance 1 week is not balance the next.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. That's good. And of course, you mentioned that, you know, your nanny, of course, is no longer with you.
Mm-hmm.
How has he been with the raising of your children and making sure it's a complete partnership?
He's amazing.
Yeah.
Scott is a wonderful father. I would sometimes tell him, you're a better father than you are a husband.
Ooh.
Because he's so good at it. No, I'm saying
He is so good at it,
but he loves, he's the youngest.
What I was doing was,
bring him back.
No.
You get it?
What happened there?
You did your thing.
That's all.
Okay. Wow. But before you even started the show, you were in the Navy.
I was.
So how did those skills help you? Not even just doing reality television, because we all know that's a beast in and of itself.
Sure.
But to come in this cast, especially of women.
Yes,
so
yes,
how did
being
in the Navy prepare you for doing a show like this?
Well, you know, a couple of things. I learned how to do conflict resolution.
Mm.
I learned to sit back sometime and just listen and kind of peep game, so to speak, like figure out what's going on, the dynamic here, like why is she acting this way? It may have nothing to do with me. Because at first even, I know Axqua can tell you, like I was just like, deer in headlights. I didn't know what was going on. I'm like, who's doing what and why? What are y'all talking about? Because everyone's relationships go back so far, predating when I came on the show.
Yeah. Right.
So I just learned how to do that from the military.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, Contessa, the fans had an opportunity to see last year you underwent surgery. You had a double mastectomy.
Mm-hmm.
And that was a very challenging time for you just to make that decision.
Yeah.
And then not only that, How difficult was it to make the decision? And then how difficult was it to have some of your counterparts, a part of Married to Medicine, who really chastised you for kind of staying away and making that decision and doing what was right for your health?
It's tough. It was. I expected all the doctors to kind of get it. I mean, Dr. Jackie was quite amazing.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah.
she understood, as a person who suffered from breast cancer, that most people don't want to have to endure the pain that she had to. But it was just hard, especially when some of the medical professionals were just not supportive.
Mm-hmm.
And I did not need their kind of, you know, endorsement.
Exactly.
I just wanted, at that point, just support,
right.
you know?
Yeah.
So it's hard when you look for it and you don't get it.
But then there's Jesus.
You made the right decision for your
health. I really
did. Yes.
Yeah. And there was no mistake. I mean, when I heard, and you know, when I post-op recovery, I woke up with a smile on my face.
Yeah.
Wow. It's just this peace, and I literally don't think about it anymore. I don't think about getting sick or breast cancer anymore.
Yes. Right. And that's what's important.
Yes. That's right.
And speaking of what's important, you as a doctor, you're a natural healer.
Yes.
Which means that you want to see people happy, healed, positive, and having a good time in life.
That's right.
What is it like, though, being in a predicament? And, you know, we talk to Quad about this all the time. What is it like being in a predicament, really all of us, where you may not get along, but it's almost, you know, purposeful to not get along sometimes right. beyond your control, but you still have to try and stay positive. Well, how do you do that?
A couple of things I live by. You know, you didn't make me, so you can't break me. Mm. So that's number one. And number two, you know, if you're unhappy, you were unhappy before me, and I had nothing to do with that. Mm. Yes. And so I stopped taking things personally that had nothing to do with me.
Yeah.
And so now I just let people be miserable by themselves, you know?
Oh my God.
And I just deflect it, and I don't internalize it.
That's real talk. Yeah.
I know who I am. You can't tell me who I am. I know who I am, you know? Mm-hmm. So that's how I learned how to deal.
You mentioned in the earlier interview that you're continuing your education. Yes. What exactly are you going to be studying? And can you tell us all of that?
So all about public health and preventive medicine. Yeah. Because this last year, that mastectomy really changed my whole view of medicine. Mm-hmm. And one thing I learned is that, one, I already knew doctors are not magicians. Yep. And there is no magic pill that I can give you. Mm-hmm. But I can help you understand how to take control of your own health.
Yes.
Things that you can do yourself. So integrative medicine. Mm-hmm. Nutrition. How to take care of you, like you. So when you come in, you just kind of let me know what's happening, and then we can manage so you can get back to taking care of you again.
Yeah. Yeah.
We don't get to learn how to do that in medicine.
Yes.
We just get to treat the disease already.
I'm so glad that you said this as a doctor, because a lot of people think that doctors, they know nutrition, they know everything about you. That's not their concentration.
No. Yeah.
Their concentration is to save your life.
That's it. Mm-hmm.
So to go back to get the nutrition part is very key,
because
they don't get that. Right.
It's all about prevention. It's not about just, we only treat diseases, and we spend all of our medicine money in treating diseases, but we don't keep people healthy, and that's what I want to do.
Oh, I'm so glad she said
that. Look at how amazing you are to already be a physician, MD, and then you turn right back around and you say, that's not good enough. I'm going back to school to get, listen, girl, I am so proud of you.
I like you.
I like you. I am so proud of you. And to go back and say, you know what, I'm going to take it a step further.
Higher.
Yes, you know, like, how hard of a decision was that, especially with being a mom, all of the schooling, and then you still have another job within Married to Medicine.
That's right. Mm.
How challenging is that? What's happening right now?
It's challenging, but once you kind of know something, you can't unknow it.
Yeah. Mm.
And once I almost, like, figured out that this is what the key to medicine is, just keeping people healthy and keeping them strong and not dealing with only sickness.
Yes.
It just, I couldn't unknow that. And I feel like I'm obligated in this position with this platform to help people understand that you contain the magic pill.
Wow. And I hope all the doctors hear you today
and
ingest that, because, you know, the medical industry is thriving off of them not wanting
better. Honey, how about that?
Because they know.
I'm going to hug you, Dr. Bridge.
I love it.
Thank you so much
for
being here and just being
me.
A light. Just truly a light. We cannot wait for the new season of Married to Medicine. Honey, you know we'll be right there, because our baby's going to be right there. We got to be ready. It's going to be starting, of course, in the to keep up with all things Dr. Contessa, be sure to follow her on Instagram at Dr. Contessa.